thing is that most guys think that they were a good husband. They never cheated on their wife. They never laid a hand on her. They provided for her financially. They did what they were supposed to do. So it comes as an utter shock that all of a sudden your wife said, I love you, but I'm no longer in love with you anymore. Like, what does that even mean? How could she actually fall in love with another guy? Want to just stop all contact? It's baffling. These guys feeling confused and honestly rageful, scrambling your brain to latch onto the things that she complained about over the years. You're thinking to yourself, okay, she said that she didn't have enough of my time. I'll come home earlier. I will take her on dates. I'll show her how much I care. It's not that I don't love her. I'll show her. Then why the hell does she get more mad when you do those things, when you put more effort in? It's literally paradoxical. This is the same exact thing Muhammad, who I'm gonna show you today, saved his marriage in a couple weeks after his wife wanted out and seeing another man, and all the other guys I work with, it's what they do, save their marriage. Because look, there is a way to change your mind, to make her fall back in love with you, and it's not too late. I think what you need more than anything else is that sense of hope that it's possible. So that's what I want to provide you today with, through Muhammad's story. All right, you have to agree with me that most experts out there will tell you one of two things how to get a woman back. They'll say, go no contact, shut her out of your life, let her know what she's missing. And the other end of the spectrum, they'll say, shower her with devotion, show her that you'll always be there for her no matter what. Give her just boundless love, just love her to death that she cannot just breathe with your, like, you get the point. But I'm telling you, both of those strategies are wrong ends of the same spectrum. And that will leave you alone on a weekend, looking at social media, watching her with your kids and another man, just bitter. Going to a bottle sometimes for a lot of guys, it's pretty bad. Now look, that will be your future if you don't listen up. Muhammad only took 3 steps to get his wife back. Now it took some time, of course, about 6 to 8 weeks, I think it was, but ultimately Muhammad did 3 major things that took his wife from seeing another man, in love with another guy, to wanting to be back with him again. If I were to ask you right now why your wife is really leaving you, do you think it's communication problems? Is it because that she has this trauma and she's super avoidant, she doesn't want to work on the problems? Or do you have some deeper sense of self-awareness and you're like, you know what, it is me. It's because I have been neglecting her, or I don't know how to communicate with her. No cheating if you've been on the channel long enough. If you don't know by now, most of those things on the surface aren't the real root reason. And the thing is that your wife will tell you that those are the reasons. It is because you weren't home enough. It is because you didn't appreciate her and all these things. But there's a deeper root reason that she's not consciously aware of. Very few women or even men or even therapists are, because therapy doesn't inform this concept. You lost your masculine edge. This is the part of you that drew her in close in the first place. Muhammad was well aware that this was lost for him because he was in the military. He was a lot more in shape and he was on that edge of life, going towards fear, developing himself. That's what attracted his wife and what attracted your wife in the first place, whether you know it or not.
So I was really, really needy. Okay. I didn't find that out till after 3 months from separation.
Some women are such a gift to us, because even Muhammad's wife told him exactly how she felt about this.
She told me, no, I just feel like you are very needy. Okay. I just feel like you're one of my sons.
If you just take a second, just right now, pause and think. Even pause this video if you have to. Did you lose your masculine edge? Have you sacrificed parts of yourself that you're passionate about? Have you learned to just give in to her when she's upset? Have you stopped leading as much because she's so stubborn and independent, right? Those are symptoms that you've lost this masculine edge and why she's no longer attracted to you or doesn't respect you as much as she used to. All right, if you've taken an honest inventory about this, I'm happy. I'm glad this is the first step, my man. But let's go into the next thing. This next step is the second step in order to start to get her back what Muhammad did. If you were to take a second and think to yourself, who's really to blame for where your marriage is at right now? I'm sure, like what I talk about, you will take some responsibility, but then your mind naturally, because it's an ego, you don't want to feel like it's all your fault. You'll say things like, it's my wife's trauma, or it's the in-laws, or it's this, it's society, it's her sister in her ear. And I get that. I'm not saying you're wrong about those things. All I'm saying is, how much control do you have over the circumstances outside of you? As an example, think about the thought experiment. Some guys will come to me, they'll say, Josh, our marriage is falling apart because of her depression. I say, okay, cart before the horse. Maybe she's depressed and sad and cold because the marriage is falling apart. She doesn't have the skills to admit that to you, to be open and vulnerable and honest, because you haven't created that space for her. But that second way of looking at it gives you power to change things, doesn't it? This extreme ownership or radical responsibility is not easy. It feels better to play the victim. I mean, I catch myself doing this all the time with business. Something goes wrong, it's like, oh, it's not me. Like, I think it's a natural ego defense mechanism. It really is natural, it's okay. But consciously, you don't want to be like everyone else. You want to restore your marriage. You want to have a fulfilling, meaningful relationship that makes you two better people, right? And the first start of this that Muhammad realized is taking that radical responsibility.
It was very helpful for me, okay? Because changed my mind a lot and changed my way how to behave. I healed. You know, I stopped taking any medication at that time, you know, like after 1 month from the program. Like I was taking medication for in depression and anxiety. I stopped taking these medications. I'm not taking it anymore. So I go to the gym, take care of myself, put myself in a priority, you know, like all these kind of stuff.
He adopted what I call here the apex mindset.
Let me show her how much I changed. And then when I'm going to set my boundaries, it's going to be very hard for her to decide to leave me.
Now, this radical responsibility is also similar to a lot of psychological studies talking about the internal locus of control. Essentially, someone with a high internal locus of control, they believe that their life, their things that happen to them are because of them. Or someone who has a low internal locus of control think, everything happens to me because I'm like a freaking leaf in the wind. Things happen to me and I can't control it. Those people are not happy. Cool. You've identified the core root issue at this point. You said, this is my fault and these are the reasons why. Now, what do you do to actually change it? Well, one of those core tenets of being a bad and needy husband, Muhammad's words, not mine.
You know, I really was a bad husband, okay?
Is sacrificing who you are. Now, what does that mean? It's kind of vague, right? It means compromising your values and your boundaries just to make her happy in the moment. I'll hear some guys who come into my group calls, they'll even say, Josh, I'm actually gonna agree with the divorce process and the separation because I think if we divorce, we'll get back together. She's happier when I'm going through the divorce. That is the biggest mistake you could possibly make. If it is in your values to keep the marriage together, to fight for the marriage by giving up to make her happy, she will lose respect for you. That's just a fact. And if she loses respect for you, she won't wanna be with you. You have to embrace, go toward that conflict with her and not be afraid of saying no to her. One of my coaches, Liz, she calls them 180 degree actions. Essentially, your ego, your needy self, your emotions want you to do things that are not necessarily comfortable, but not uncomfortable. And she says, you need to take the exact opposite approach. Go toward that fear, take that risk, because that's what's going to be the payoff. For Muhammad, he had one of these moments. And on the surface, it seemed innocent, but it was the moment that turned the table with his wife to get her to come back to him.
What happened that really changed her mind was on my birthday. So on my birthday, she bought me a gift and it was a very expensive gift. So when she came home, she gave me the gift. I didn't accept the gift from her. I put it in the package, sealed it out, put the shipping label to her address, and I write a letter. I told her, okay, thank you for remembering my birthday. This is meaning a lot to me, but I'm not going to accept this gift from you because I don't feel it. From now, I'm a different person. I'm not doing something that I don't really feel it.
When your wife starts to see your changes and you are taking responsibility and ownership of the core issue, she will test to see if it's real and genuine change. I've seen this far too many times where this is the moment where the wife will come back into your life. She'll offer almost like a breadcrumbs of like validation and compromise and wanting to see you or give you something to see if you accept those breadcrumbs or if you'll say, no, I want it all or nothing. You see, by Muhammad accepting his wife's gift, it's accepting the terms that she has with this other man saying, hey, I'll have you as a friend. You can have all the benefits of me being your wife in terms of the financial and we have respect amongst each other. I wouldn't say respect, just cordialness. And you were gonna accept this. Literally that gift was saying, you're accepting my treaty that you're my friend. Muhammad said, no, if you want me back in your life, it's under the context of husband and wife.
Because now if I'm gonna set my boundaries, I have no value.
Now, this is how he set his boundary with her.
So maybe in the future, if there is a future between us, again, if there is another life, then even a card from you is going to mean a lot to me. But for now, I just feel like it means nothing. So, and I'm not going to consider you as a friend. So basically, I'm not going to accept that, you know, as a friendship gift.
You won't believe what happened next.
At the night, she came late at the night at around 1 a.m. She knocked the door. I opened the door and she told me like, I wish you were this person before. And you showed me like this kind of personality. Believe me, I would never left you.
His wife uttered the words for the longest time he was desperate to hear. But in that moment, they didn't carry as much emotional weight to him. You see, Muhammad knew in that moment what I teach, which is pretty much everything your wife does to challenge you is a test. David Deida says it best in his book, The Way of the Superior Man. A woman often seems to test her man's capacity to remain unperturbed in his truth and purpose. She tests him to feel his freedom and depth of love, to know that he is trustable. Her test may come in the form of complaining, challenging him, changing her mind, doubting him, distracting him, or even undermining his purpose in a subtle or not so subtle way. A man should never think his woman's testing is going to end and his life will get easier. Rather, he should appreciate that she does these things to feel his strength, integrity, and openness. Her desire is for his deepest truth and love. As he grows, so will her testing. Your wife, girlfriend, has to know one thing, that you want her in your life, that you are happy if she is back in your life under the right boundaries. She will test those boundaries. She'll see if you'll compromise. and she will give you the gift of her feminine, open, loving nature if you establish your frame in your tests, if you pass her tests.
She and I go back into the house, start give a real opportunity to our marriage, and we're going to work together on this. I told her, okay, but I have some conditions to do that. She said, what kind of conditions? Now you put a condition to, you know, to ask you to go back to my house. I said, it's not about just coming back to your house, you know, to the life, but basically it's, we're building a new life. So there's some stuff that I want to make sure is going to be in the right direction, you know. He said, what? So I said, if you're going to go back to my house, then we're not friends anymore. You're going to be wife and husband. We bought a new wedding ring. Okay, she stopped the process about the divorce, and she's living with me right now.
Look, if you want another story about how one of my clients got his wife back apologizing after she was in love with another man, check out Sean's story on the video right here, video card, and I have a whole playlist of all the marriages I saved. You know how else I can help you if you need. See you in the next one. Subscribe if you're new here. Cheers.